Dear students, how are you? At the last class, I taught you electrochemical cell, that means galvanic cell, dry cell, and I told you that there are two types of cell. Number one is electrochemical and number two is electrolytic cell. Today we are going to explain about electrolytic cell and electrolysis. At first, come to electrolysis. Electrolytic cell is such type of cell where chemical reaction can take place by the influence of electricity. It's known as electrolytic cell. And electrolysis. Come to electrolysis. Electrolysis is the process in which electricity is passed through a molten or liquid state of a compound to divide this into oppositely charged ion. It's known as electrolysis. Have you understood? The process in which electricity is passed through a molten or liquid state of a solution to divide the compound into oppositely charged ion is known as electrolysis. For performing electrolysis, we need electrolytic cell. That means which cell is used for performing electrolysis is known as electrolytic cell. See, the process of electrolysis of molten sodium chloride. Molten means whenever it is not solution but little bit wet. There is water, little bit water. So, whenever sodium chloride, molten sodium chloride ionizes, it produces sodium ion and chloride ion. For performing electrolysis, we need a container. This container is known as electrolytic tank. This container is known as electrolytic tank. Two electrodes is needed. Two metallic electrodes is needed for this purpose. One is anode, another one is cathode. Then, for your kind information, the major difference between electrochemical cell and electrolytic cell is, in case of electrochemical cell, you found that anode is negative. Anode was negative. But in case of electrolytic cell, anode is positive, cathode is negative. This is the major difference between electrochemical cell and electrolytic cell. Then, one electrolyte, here sodium chloride, molten sodium chloride is used as electrolyte. Anode is attached with the positive end of battery, cathode is attached with the negative end of the battery. Then electricity is passed. Whenever electricity is passed, that time in sodium is cation. Cation is attracted by the negative electrode. Here negative electrode is cathode. So sodium will be attracted by cathode and cation will be attracted by anode. That means chloride ion will go towards the anode. After going to the anode, each chlorine atom will donate one electron. That means two chlorine atoms will donate two electrons and will be converted into chlorine gas. This process is known as oxidation. And as sodium ion is going to cathode, each sodium ion will receive one electron and produce sodium atom. This process is known as reduction. This is the mechanism of electrolysis. or electrolysis of molten sodium chloride. Dear students, now come to the electrolysis of brine. Before going to the electrolysis of brine, you have to know what is brine. Saturated aqueous solution of sodium chloride is called brine. That means solution of sodium chloride, saturated solution. What is saturated solution? Such type of solution where solute is fully mixed. The solute is mixed with the solvent equally everywhere is known as saturated solution. And such type of solution where solute doesn't become soluble everywhere equally in a solvent is known as unsaturated solution. So saturated aqueous solution of sodium chloride is called brine. So now come to the electrolysis of brine. For this purpose we have to take a electrolytic tank or container. Here one electrolyte is taken. What is electrolyte? In this case electrolyte is brine. And as brine is aqueous solution with sodium chloride, there is water. Two electrodes are used over there, two metallic rod. Two platinum rod is used as anode and cathode. Anode is positive electrode, cathode is negative electrode. Then sodium chloride ionizes into sodium ion and chloride ion. And water molecule ionizes into hydrogen ion and hydroxyl ion. That means total four ions are present over here. Cation is sodium ion, hydrogen ion. Anion is chloride ion, hydroxyl ion. Now, whenever electricity is passed, that time chloride ion, as the concentration of chloride ion is higher, it goes toward the anode. And after going to the anode, two chlorine atoms, each chlorine atom releases one electron and produces chlorine atom. So therefore, two chlorine ion releases two electrons and produce chlorine gas. And so hydrogen ion, sodium ion, both can be attracted by the cathode. But as the reducing tendency of hydrogen ion, that means electron accepting tendency of hydrogen ion is more, that's why hydrogen ion is attracted by the cathode. After going to the cathode, each hydrogen atom receives one electron and produce hydrogen atom. One hydrogen ion receives one electron and produce hydrogen atom. Therefore, two hydrogen ion receives two electrons and produce hydrogen gas. So what is remaining? Chlorine is becoming oxidized. Hydrogen ion is becoming reduced. So what is remaining? Sodium ion and hydroxyl ion is remaining in the solution. This remaining sodium ion and hydrogen ion combine together with each other and produce sodium hydroxide. This is the electrolysis of brine.
Dear learners,
now come to the electrolysis of acid mixed water. Now you can ask me, miss, why it is acid mixed water? Why not pure water? Because pure water can't be ionized. For ionization, we have to mix a little amount of sulfuric acid or another acid with water. After mixing sulfuric acid, water can be ionized partially and produce hydrogen ion and hydroxyl ion. Then what is happening? Hydroxyl ion goes to the anode. Before that, I am showing you the structure. In this case, we have to take a electrolytic tank. In this tank, we are taking acidified water. Anode and cathode, two electrodes are used over there. Anode and cathode must be used of inert gas. Anode and cathode must be made by any inert metal. Suppose platinum, stainless steel, such type of metal, iridium. Whenever anode and cathode is placed, that time anode and cathode will be connected with a battery. Anode will be connected with the positive end. Anode is positive, cathode is negative. So, anode will be connected with the positive end and cathode will be connected with the negative end of the battery. Then electricity is passed. Whenever electricity is passed, that time hydroxyl ion will go to anode and will be oxidized and will produce oxygen. Cathode will go, hydrogen ion will go to cathode and will be reduced. Now, hydrogen ion is receiving electron and producing hydrogen gas. The overall reaction is like this. Water molecule is equals to oxygen plus hydrogen plus water. Here, after electrolysis, whenever electrolysis is taking place, we will find that oxygen is deposited on the anode and hydrogen is deposited towards the cathode and hydrogen is deposited towards the anode. Then if we collect hydrogen and oxygen gas, we will find that the amount of hydrogen is double of oxygen. Why it is double? Because the formula of water is H2O. Here double amount of hydrogen is present than oxygen. By this way, we can collect hydrogen and oxygen from water. That means water molecule can be broken down into oxygen and hydrogen. This is the electrolysis of acidified water. Students, now come to electroplating. What is electroplating? The coating of the process in which coating of one metal is given on another metal is known as electroplating. By electrolysis process, you have to mention the process. By which process? Electrolysis. Again, I am saying, the process of coating one metal on another metal by the process of electrolysis is known as electroplating. Suppose we want to give a layering of silver on iron metal. That time electroplating is done. How it is done? By electrolysis. In this case, we have to take a beaker or electrolytic tank. In this tank, we will take silver nitrate solution as an electrolyte. Here, I want to do electroplating on iron metal by silver. So this one spoon has been taken for electroplating. This spoon is made by iron. It will act as cathode. And a silver strip will be taken. This one is silver strip. a silver step will be taken as anode. This one is anode, this one is cathode. Then electricity is passed. Whenever electricity is passed, that time silver at the anode, silver will release electron and produce silver ion. Whenever electricity is passed, that time silver will release electron and will produce silver ion. And this silver ion from will go to the cathode from anode. After going to the cathode, it will be reduced. How will it be reduced? It will receive one electron. Silver ion will receive one electron and will produce silver atom. And this silver will be deposited, this silver metal will be deposited on the surface of the spoon. By this process, coating of silver will be done on iron. This is called electroplating. Now, what is the purpose of electroplating? To protect the metallic corrosion, electroplating is done. And sometimes electroplating is done for increasing the brightness of the metal. Number two, less reactive metal doesn't react with oxygen. That's why to protect the oxidation of metal, electroplating is done by less reactive metal. Number three, to increase the toughness and stability of metal, electroplating is done. These are the purpose of electroplating. Now come to zinc plating. What is zinc plating? The coating of tin plating. The coating of tin on the surface of another metal is known as tin plating. Then galvanizing. The coating of zinc on the surface of another metal, most of the time it is on tin, is known as galvanizing. Okay? So dear students, today up to this I have finished electrolysis of molten sodium chloride, electrolysis of brine, electrolysis of acidified water, electroplating, tin plating, galvanizing. Okay. Next class I will show you nuclear reaction. So today up to this, thank you.